Alternative energy is important to Lakeland College for many reasons. One of the most important is we really need to be good stewards of the resources that we're in charge of and make sure that we're creating a better future for generations to follow. Lakeland College started our journey on sustainability about 18 years ago, and it started with our geothermal wells and our geothermal loop that helps heat and cool the college. We've taken that concept as one of the first geothermal loops in the nation, and that closed loop system has evolved today where we have over 600 wells that help heat and cool every single building on campus.
So we started in 2012 with Lindsay Call, with everyone calls them the sunflowers, the four or five arrays that ended up being 20 kilowatts of electricity. 2014, we went to the West Building. That was 100 kilowatts. Also in 2014, we went to Votech, and that's 80 kilowatts. And Webb Hall was 112 kilowatts. Then in 2020, we did a big grant and pushed a lot of buildings with Neal Hall, Northeast, and Luther Student Center. All the solar that we produce, we use on campus.
So although the footprint of the campus has grown considerably in the 18 years since we started these initiatives, we have reduced our natural gas consumption by 63% during that same period of time. So although we've seen about a 15% increase in the footprint on campus, we've actually used 63% fewer levels of natural gas than we would have in the future. And the same thing holds true for electricity. So when we look at our electricity consumption with what we've been able to do with sustainable energy generation through photovoltaic, through at one point in time wind power, we've been able to reduce our reliance on outside electricity by 33%. And so you put those pieces together and you're creating an environment that overall saves our community, our taxpayers, the Lakeland College District about $500,000 a year. Students can take part in helping to be sustainable on campus. We do a lot of recycling. We have one of the only remaining recycling centers in the area. So we encourage students through our receptacles on campus to recycle all of their plastics, their glass, their aluminum, their paper, to ensure that they can become part of our initiative to make a better world for the future. We have great partners on campus with our sustainability initiatives. One of our biggest has been Verigy, who has helped to basically oversee much of the sustainability initiatives on campus for the past 18 years. What I love about Lakeland College is we are in an environment where our Board of Trustees fully supports us moving forward with additional sustainability initiatives. So some of the things we're working on in the future are looking at adding additional photovoltaic on the roofs of our buildings. We currently have 7 buildings on campus that have photovoltaic on the roofs of the buildings or solar panels. Our goal is to ensure that every building on campus has solar panels. We have plans for the Effingham Technology Center to increase our sustainability there through the use of photovoltaics. We have wide open spaces there on the roofs of the building and elsewhere that are perfect for us to use those sustainable resources. We could continue to make improvements on our geothermal system so that system can become more and more efficient. And finally, although we've made really good strides in the last 18 years, we still use a lot of fluorescent lighting on campus. And our hope is that we can continue to replace fluorescent lighting with LEDs, which will again fully reduce our reliance on electricity and natural gas and other natural resources, so that hopefully at some point in time, maybe in the not too distant future, Lakeland College will truly become a sustainable institution.